Hello students, welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. In the previous lecture, we have started with chapter 3, polynomials. And in that, we have seen different types of polynomials. First, we saw the types of polynomials based on the number of terms in the polynomial. Then, we saw the polynomials which are based on the type, that means the degree, what degree that polynomial possess, that we have seen. See here, types of polynomial based on terms, and we classified them as monomial, binomial and trinomial. Monomial means polynomial with one term, binomial means polynomial with two terms, and trinomial means polynomial with three terms. And when we have more terms, we term it as a polynomial. And for writing the polynomial, we use this form, that is P of x. Okay, this particular symbol is used to write polynomial. Whatever variable is there is written in the bracket. Okay, so these are the examples of some polynomials. Then we have seen about the degree of polynomial in one variable. Whenever the polynomial is in one variable, the highest degree or the highest power of the variable is called as the degree of the polynomial. For example, here 2x raised to 7 minus 5x plus 9, the degree here is 7. Why? Because the highest power of the variable is 7. So for the polynomial in one variable, you will always observe the highest power. Okay, but when the degree is in more than when the polynomial is in more than one variable, then we have to add the powers of variables in each term and then check the highest sum, that is our degree of polynomial. For example, here you can see 3 plus 6 is 9, 2 plus 3 is 5, and here 1 plus 1 is 2. So the highest sum here is 9, and therefore the degree of the polynomial is 9. Okay, then we have seen the polynomials in one variable and their type based on the degree. So when the degree of the polynomial is 1, it is called as linear polynomial. The standard form is ax plus b. The condition is that a cannot be 0. Then the second one is called as quadratic polynomial. Degree is 2. Standard form, you can see ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, here again the condition is what? A cannot be 0. Cubic polynomial means degree is 3. Standard form is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Again, condition is what? A cannot be 0. Why? Because we want degree 3 here. Okay. So, this we have seen in the previous lecture. Then, we have seen the definition of polynomial. Okay. So, an x raised to n plus an minus 1 x raised to n minus 1 up to a1x plus a0. You can see it is written in the decreasing order of the powers of the variable. Okay, so such expression is called as polynomial. Here, polynomial in x with degree n. Here, this an, an minus 1, a2, a1, a0, all these are called as coefficients. Again, the condition is what? An cannot be 0. Why? Because here degree is n, so this coefficient cannot be 0. So this is definition of polynomial. Okay, then we have seen, we have learnt about the standard form, coefficient form and the index form of the polynomial. Okay, so first of all, we have taken one example. See, px is equal to x minus 3x square plus 5 plus x raised to 4. This is polynomial. Okay, so here you will find that the powers are not in the proper order, either ascending order or descending order. But when we arrange these terms according to the descending order of the powers, it is called as the standard form of the polynomial. Simply, we have to arrange the terms according to the descending order of the powers. That means the term with highest power we have to write first, and then we have to go on decreasing it. Okay, so this is called as standard form. Here you will find that after x raised to 4, you have term with x square. So here term with x cube is missing. So when we write these missing terms, that time it becomes the index form of the polynomial. Okay. So here when we write that missing term here, like see, x cube was missing. So we wrote coefficient 0 for that, and then here this is called as index form. How to check whether the index form is correct or what? So see here, here the degree of the polynomial is 4. So in that case, we should have 5 terms in that particular polynomial. Okay, degree plus 1, that many terms should be present. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so this is called as index form of the polynomial. And finally, coefficient form. The name itself suggests that when we write only coefficients here in round brackets, that is called as coefficient form. Okay. So same example is not taken here. The another example is taken in textbook. So see here the coefficient is 1. Here it is minus 3, 0 and minus 8. When we write these coefficients in bracket separated by comma, then this is called as coefficient form of the polynomial. Okay, this is what we have studied. Then we have seen one example here, and here you can see all the forms, standard form, then index form. See, in standard form we are not writing the missing terms, but in index form we are writing the missing terms with coefficient 0. Okay, and for writing the coefficient form, this index form is very, very important. Okay. Without index form, you cannot write coefficient form. Like how to check? Here if degree is 5, then you should have 6 coefficients here. Then only you are correct. If without writing the missing terms, if you write, you will get only 4 coefficients. So in that case, the degree of the polynomial will become 3, which is wrong. We have 5, so we should have 6 terms. This way, for writing the coefficient form, writing index form is essential. Okay, this you have to keep in mind. So this is what we have studied in the previous lecture. Now let us go further. Now we will start with practice set 3.1. Okay, so here certain questions we can solve orally. So what you will do is you will take out your textbook, notebook and pencil and pen, and go on writing the answers along with me. Okay. Here I have not solved the sums actually. I am only going to discuss. You are going to write them by yourself. Okay. So here, see for example the first one. State whether the given algebraic expressions are polynomials. Justify. Means we have to check whether they are polynomials or what. If they are polynomials, why they are polynomials, and if they are not, then why they are not. Okay. So here, first one, see, you can see y plus 1 upon y. Okay. So this 1 upon y, when you will take in numerator, it is going to become y raised to minus 1. Okay. But what is our condition? That the indices should be whole numbers. Or the powers of the variable should be whole numbers. And this minus 1 is not a whole number. Okay. Therefore, this first one is not a polynomial. Okay. So, you will write this polynomial again. That y plus 1 upon y is equal to y plus y raised to minus 1. And here, since the power of the variable is negative, it is not a polynomial. Okay. Similarly, second one now here, 2 minus 5 root x. This root x we can write as x raised to half. Correct? Square root we can write this way. Again, observe the power now. Is half a whole number? No. So, again, this is not a polynomial. Why? Because the index is not a whole number. Correct? So, here this one is not a polynomial. Why? Because the index is negative number, not a whole number. This is also not a polynomial. Why? Because the index is a fraction, not a whole number. थर्ड वन x स्क्वायर प्लस 7x प्लस 9 यस इमीडिएटली यू विल से दैट इट्स अ पॉलिनोमियल व्हाई बिकॉज यू कैन सी ऑल द पावर्स हियर 2 देन 1 एंड हियर 0 दे आर होल नंबर्स ओके सो दिस इज अ पॉलिनोमियल देन फोर्थ वन हियर ऑल्सो इमीडिएटली यू कैन राइट डाउन द जस्टिफिकेशन यू कैन सी द पावर इज नेगेटिव हियर माइनस 2 So not a polynomial. So you can write down this is not a polynomial because the power of the variable is negative. This one, is it a polynomial? Yes. We have studied that whenever only number appears or only coefficient appears, it is called as a constant polynomial. Even though the variable is not seen, that variable is present there, you know that the variable present here is having the power 0, x raised to 0. You know that anything raised to 0 is 1. So, even though the variable is not seen here, you can say that it's a polynomial. Also, it is called as constant polynomial. Okay? So, it was very easy. I hope you will write by yourself. Then, now the second one, write the coefficient of n cube in each of the given polynomial. Okay, that means here three different polynomials are provided to us and there we have to write down the coefficient of n cube. So, see here, in the first one, no number is seen. That means 1 is present there by default. So, coefficient of n cube here is 1. Here you can see the coefficient of n cube is minus root 3. Take the sign also along with it. Okay, don't forget the sign. Don't write only root 3. There is plus root 3. So take it along with the sign. So in the second case, the coefficient is minus root 3. Because we have to find coefficient of n cube only. And here in the third one, the coefficient is minus 2 upon 3. So, in this way, we have found out all the coefficients. Here it is 1. Here it is minus root 3. And here it is minus 2 upon 3. Okay, so they have asked us only about the coefficient of m cube. So, we are going to write that only. Okay, then next is you have to write the polynomial in x using the given information. This is open-ended question. You can write any answer of your choice. Only the condition should be satisfied. For example, here you want to write down monomial with degree 7. That means you have to take variable x because they have told that use only x and degree should be 7. So, highest index should be 7. Then here in front of this, you cannot write anything because you want monomial. Okay. If you want, you can write down any number in front of that. Like I am writing 3 x raised to 7. I want monomial with degree 7. That means the polynomial should have only one term and its highest index should be 7. Okay. So, this is one example given by me. You can write any other coefficient here. But this x raised to 7 should be present there. Because we want monomial with degree 7 and the variable also is given, that is x. So, you can write any of your choice. Now, second one, binomial with degree 35. Okay. So, that means x raised to 35. Should be present here. You can add any number for, say for example, minus 2 I am writing. But it's a binomial. That means I want one more term here. So that term can be anything. It can be having degree. Suppose I am writing x square here. You can write only x. You can write any number also. So this way you can write any example of your choice. Similarly, third one now, trinomial with degree 8. Okay, so you have to write down the trinomial with degree 8 means what? You should have the highest index as 8. That means term with x raised to 8 should be present. And trinomial means what? You want more two terms here. Say for I am writing here 2x minus 3. Okay, so this is my trinomial. Okay, so this way you can write any. You can take any order less than 8 here. Somebody will write plus 2x raised to 7 minus 3x. Then also correct. That is why I told that it's a open-ended question. Okay, so this way you can complete question number 1, question number 2 and question number 3. I hope many of you have completed along with me only. Okay, if you want, you can write in the textbook there and there only with pencil that, and otherwise you can write in your notebook also. Okay, so this way we have completed question number 1, 2 and 3. Okay, now let us go further. Question number 4, again we are solving in the same way. Write the degree of the given polynomial. Okay, so here also you have to simply write down the degree. So observe here, first one here, root 5. Root 5 means only coefficient is present, it's a constant polynomial. Then the degree here is what? 0. You know that degree of constant polynomial is 0. Here x raised to 0 means 1. Again the constant polynomial. So again the degree is 0. Here you can say what is the degree here? The highest power 2. So degree is 2. Here degree is 10. You can see the highest power here. Here degree is 1. Nothing is present means 1 is present there by default. Here the terms are not arranged properly, but you have to only go for the highest index. So here also you can see that 5 is the highest index. So degree is 5. Here now this is the polynomial with more than one variables. Okay. In this case, in the first 4 questions, you will observe that the polynomials are having only one variable. Okay. Here it is m, here it is p. Here it is only y. So we have considered the highest index. But here, see now, the polynomials, they are having more than one variable. In that case, what I told you, that you have to add all the powers. Okay, so here 1, and here 1. So the highest here is 3 we got here. Here 1, and here 1. So here sum is 2. And here the sum is 1. So you will go for the highest sum, that is 3. So degree of the polynomial here is 3. You show here 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 here. And here only 1. So we have to think of the highest sum. So the degree here is 3. Similarly here when you add 3 plus 7, what you are going to get? 10. When you add this 5 plus 1, you are going to get 6 here for this term. And for this term, 1 and 1, you are going to get 2. So see the highest sum here, it is 10. So the degree of this particular polynomial is 10. This way, simply you can do it orally or you can do it there and there only by writing the answers. Okay, so you are going to write it by yourself. Then next question, classify the following polynomials as linear, quadratic and cubic polynomial. Just now we have revised what is meaning of linear polynomial, what is meaning of quadratic polynomial, what is meaning of cubic polynomial. Linear polynomial means what? The highest index should be 1. Quadratic means what? The highest index should be 2. And cubic means what? The highest index should be 3. So only observe the highest index. For example, Here the highest index is 2. So this is a quadratic polynomial. Write down here. This is a quadratic polynomial. Here 5p means 5p raised to 1. Okay, so the highest index is 1. So this is linear polynomial. Here, can you guess again? The highest index is 1 or highest power is 1. So again it's a linear polynomial. Fourth one, observe the highest index. It is 3. So it's a cubic polynomial. Correct? Only you have to observe the index. Then here, the highest index is 2. So it's a quadratic polynomial. This one, the index is 3, means cubic polynomial. Okay? So this way, simply by observing the highest powers or the indices, you can decide whether the polynomial is linear, quadratic or cubic. Okay? So let us go further now. Question number 6. Write the following polynomials in standard form. So here two questions are given. So let us discuss. First one is very easy. So this you will solve as homework. I am solving second one. Because second one is lengthy also. Okay. So first of all, write the given polynomial as it is. This is our question. Then we have to go further. We have to write down the standard form. Then you know that what is meaning of standard form? Standard form means polynomial you will simply write in the descending order of the powers of the variables. Okay, so observe here, what is the highest index? 5. So this term we will write first. Now while rearranging the terms, you have to rearrange them along with the signs. So first one is plus, so we are not writing plus. The first term is y raised to 5. After that, the term with y raised to 4 should appear. So take that complete term along with the signs. Plus 2y raised to 4. Then you should have term with cube. So write that complete term along with the sign. Plus 3y cube. After that, you should have term with square. So write that term minus y square here. See, you can see minus y square. As I am telling you that take it along with the sign. Don't write plus here, otherwise you will be wrong. Then after y square, you should have term with y. That is minus 7y. So write that term. And finally, the constant term. That is minus half. Okay. So this way we have written the polynomial in the standard form. You write it down, complete it, and first one you have to solve as homework. See here, only you have to rearrange. So first term here will be n cube, second term will be 5m and third term will be plus 3. Only you will shift this term this side, that will be your standard form. Okay, so complete it. It's very easy to understand. Try to understand the difference between standard form and index form here. In standard form, we are not thinking about the missing terms. But in index form, we have to think about the missing terms here. Okay? So let us go further now. Question number 7. Write the following polynomials in coefficient form. Okay? So here, the polynomials are given. They may be in standard form or they may not be in standard form. Okay, so first of all, we have to write down the polynomials in standard form. Then, we have to write down the polynomials in index form and then in coefficient form. I told you previously that for writing the coefficient form, it is important or it is compulsory to write down the index form. Okay, so let us start now. Question number 1, see, x cube minus 2. Always you will observe the degree here. Degree is 3. So in this particular polynomial, you should have 3 plus 1, 4 terms. But you will observe that here only 2 terms are present. That means 2 terms are missing. The term with x square is missing and the term with x also is missing. So first of all, we have to write the polynomial in standard form. Then we have to write down in index form and then we can go for the coefficient form. Okay. So here it is already in standard form. So I am writing index form. So write the term with the highest power of variable x cube. Afterwards, as I told, that term with x square is missing. So write down that term with 0 as a coefficient. Okay. So x cube plus 0x square. Also the term with x is missing. So write down that term also, but don't forget to take 0 as the coefficient. And finally write down minus 2. So now check. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 terms are present. That means our index form is correct. Now by using this index form, it is very easy to write down coefficient form. Simply all the coefficients present here, we need to write in round bracket. Okay. So let us write down the coefficient form in round bracket. The first coefficient is 1. I told you many times, whenever nothing is seen, 1 is always present there. So the coefficient here is 1. Then put comma. Second coefficient here is 0. Third is again 0. And the last one is minus 2. Whenever you have minus sign, you need to write it. You cannot write simply 2. Then that 2 will be considered as positive. And you will go wrong. Okay. So here, for writing the coefficient form, writing the polynomial is in index form is very, very important. Okay. So complete this sum. First one. Now let us go for the next one. Second one I am taking. Second one, only one term is provided. 5y. So here degree is 1. So here we should have 1 plus 1, 2 terms. Okay. So we have to write it in index form. And then we have to write down the missing term. So here, since the degree is 1 here, the next term is a constant term. That means only number. So we will simply write 0 in front of that because this term is missing. Okay. So now we have 2 terms, 1 and 2. Now writing the coefficient form is very easy. Write in brackets. Here the coefficient is 5 and comma and coefficient of second term is 0. Okay. So here you can observe that when degree is 1, there are 2 coefficients here in coefficient form. Okay. So this way you have to complete it. Write it down. Then let us go further. Third one, you can write by yourself. You solve by yourself. It is same similar to first one. Here the degree is 4. That means you should have 5 terms. So find out the missing terms here. Like here the term m cube is missing. So write down that as 0 m raised to 3. Also after m square you should have a term with m that is missing. So write that term as 0m. So you will get 5 terms here and then it is possible for you to write down the coefficient form. I have taken fourth one here. See, this is minus 2 upon 3. You know that it is called as a constant polynomial. Okay. Constant polynomial degree is 0. That means here only one term is present. No term is missing. Okay. So you can write down directly the coefficient form here. Because index form we need not write. Because no term is missing. So directly you can write down the coefficient form as minus 2 upon 3 in round brackets. Okay. So this way you are going to write coefficient forms. I hope you must have understood this. Okay. Complete it. And don't forget to do the homework. Whatever sums are given for homework, you need to do them immediately. Okay? So that you will get better practice. Let us go further now. Next question, question number 8. Write the polynomials in standard form. Okay, exactly opposite of question number 7. There, standard form was given and we need to write coefficient form. And here, coefficient form is given and we need to write the standard form. Now, whenever it is given in this way, by default, we are going to take variable x. Okay, generally, we are writing variable x only whenever it is not given. Okay, so let us start. Question number 1, see the coefficients 1, 2 and 3. So count them here. How many are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 coefficients are there. So subtract 1 from that. 3 minus 1 is 2. That means here this polynomial is having degree 2. Okay. So here the variable x is having highest index as 2. Which we can write for this number. Then go on decreasing. Here it will appear x and this is constant. Okay. So it's possible for us to write down the index form. So see, as I have said, degree is 2. So here coefficient is 1. So 1 into x square is x square. We are not writing 1 here. Then plus 2x plus 3. Okay. Simply in front of these numbers, you have to go on writing the variables with the proper powers. For example, here in front of this we are going to write x square. Here in front of 2 we are going to write x. Because after x square, it is going to be x raised to 1. That is x only. And finally, plus 3. Okay, so this is the index form. Okay, and same is the standard form. Because no term is missing here. Okay. So here we can write down the index form and standard form, which is same. Okay. Even if you skip this, it's okay. Even if you don't write index form, it's okay. Directly you can go for the standard form. Then also you are correct. Okay. So let us go further. Question number 2 now here. See. 5, 0, 0, 0 and -1. So count. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are 5 coefficients. So 5 minus 1, that is 4. So here the polynomial should have degree 4. That means here the first term is having the variable x raised to 4. Okay. So from this we can write down the things. First we are writing coefficient form. Copied as it is from the question. Now from this we can write down the index form. As I have said, I have decided that here the highest index is 4. So in front of the first number, I am going to write x raised to 4. Okay, 5x raised to 4. Then plus 0x cube plus 0x square plus 0x and finally minus 1. Okay, so this is index form. But we need to write standard form. So in standard form, we are not writing missing terms. So all these terms which are having coefficient 0, we will ignore them while writing the standard forms. Okay. So the standard form is 5x raised to 4 minus 1. Okay. So this way you can complete it. So first two I have solved for you. Third one you will solve as homework. Okay. So today we are stopping here. In the next lecture we will learn about more concepts in polynomials. Okay. So thank you students. Stay home. Stay safe. Take care of yourself.